Welcome you all, myself Professor Shilpa Raut from KK Wagh College of Pharmacy, Nasik. Today we are going to see the topic Introduction to Biotechnology. Biotechnology is the use of living system and organism to develop or make a useful product or any technological application that uses biological system, living organisms or derivatives thereof to make or modify products or processes for specific use. European Federation of Biotechnology has defined biotechnology as an integration of natural science and organism, cells, parts of thereof and molecular analogues for products and services. The European Association of Pharma Biotechnology, that is EAPB, defines pharmaceutical biotechnology as a science of covering all technologies required for production, manufacturing, registration of biological drugs. Pharmaceutical biotechnology is a relatively new and growing field in which the principles of biotechnology are applied to the development of drugs. Means by using these principles of biotechnology, now pharma field produces different drugs. A majority of therapeutic drugs in the current market are bioformulations such as antibodies, nucleic acid products and vaccines. These are the products which are produced by using the biotechnological principle. These are the few examples of traditional biotechnological products, that is secondary metabolites, antibiotics, steroids and vitamins. And modern biotechnology includes recombinant protein, monoclonal antibodies, gene therapy, transgenic organism, making a bread and curd with the help of microorganism. Yeast species are used for the production of bread. Then lactobacilli are used for the production of curd. These are the few oldest example of the biotechnology used in a food industry. Then these biotechnological principles are also used in production of wine and alcoholic beverages. Is also a biotechnological technique by using the fermentation. These alcohols and wine are produced. Now we'll see some historical events of this biotechnology. In 1797, Jenner inoculated child with viral vaccine to protect him from smallpox. In 1857, Pasteur proposes that microbes causes fermentation. Then in 1928, penicillin is discovered by Fleming. In 1944, Avery proves DNA as a carrier of genetic information. Then Waksman isolates streptomycin as an antibiotic for tuberculosis. Then in 1953, structural elucidation of double helix of DNA. Then in 1967, first protein sequencer is perfected. In 1970, discovery of restriction enzyme used as the molecular scissors for cutting of this DNA fragment. In 1973, Cohen and Boyer produces first recombinant DNA in bacteria with restriction enzymes and ligases. In 1977, first expression of human protein in bacteria. in 1980 US patent for gene cloning to Cohen and Boyer. In 1981 first transgenic animal is produced. In 1982 Humulin as a first recombinant biotechnological drug approved by FDA. Humulin is nothing but insulin. Means this insulin is produced based on the biotechnological principle and its brand name is Humulin and it is approved in 1982 for the treatment of diabetes. In 1983 invention of PCR is there, that is polymerase chain reaction. In 1986 first recombinant vaccine for hepatitis B is produced. In 1988 US patent for genetically modified mouse. In 1990 launching human genome project. In 1994 approval of DNAs for cystic fibrosis. In 1997 first animal clone from adult cell, that is dolly sheep. In year 2000 rough draft of human genome is announced. In 2002 draft version of complete map of human genome is published. First oligonucleotide drug is approved by FDA. Now common pharmaceutical biotechnological products. Antibiotics, proteins, recombinant DNA products. We'll move to the first, that is antibiotics. These are the proteins that are produced by white blood cells and are used by immune system to identify bacteria, viruses and other foreign substances and to fight them off. In recent years, monoclonal antibodies are one of the most exciting developments in biotechnology pharmaceuticals. Example, actinin alpha monoclonal antibodies, then actin smooth muscle monoclonal antibodies, then proteins made up of amino acid are large complex molecule that do most the work in cell. These are the building blocks of our body, are required for structure, functional regulation of body's tissue and organ. Protein biotechnology is emerging as one of the key technology in future for understanding development of many diseases like cancer or amyloid formation for better therapeutic intervention. Recombinant DNA products is genetically engineered DNA created by recombining fragments of DNA from different organisms. Some of them recombinant DNA product includes recombinant DNA vaccines, then drugs, enzymes, then growth hormones, then insulin, yeast, then proteins. All of these are produced by using the recombinant DNA technology and used in the pharmaceutical field. Recombinant vaccine. This vaccine is produced through the rDNA technology. It involves inserting the DNA encoding an antigen that stimulates an immune response into bacterial or mammalian cell, expressing the antigen in the cell and then purifying it from them. Means the antigen responsible DNA responsible for the particular antigen is inserted into the bacteria or the mammalian cell. Then large scale production of that particular antigen is there by using the rDNA technology, and then isolation of that particular antigen from that microorganism, from that cell, and then it is used as the vaccine after purification. For example, hepatitis B infection, control through use of recombinant hepatitis B vaccine. Then recombinant DNA drugs, we already seen that is Humulin is the brand name for the insulin used in treatment of diabetes. Then Humatrops, that is growth hormone used for the deficiency syndrome, somatotropin deficiency syndrome. Then Forteo, that is parathyroid hormone treatment of osteoporosis in women and men. rDNA enzymes, that is chymosin used for the production of cheese. Then growth hormone, that is protropin, support the growth and development. Then rDNA insulin, that is Humulin. Then rDNA protein, that is tissue plasminogen activator, it is used for the breakdown of the blood clots for the cardiac patient. Then applications of this biotechnology: insulin is produced in bacteria. Then erythropoietin used to treat the anemia by stimulating the red blood cell production. Then growth hormone also produced by using rDNA technology during the somatotropin deficiency, in case of somatotropic deficiency. Then factor 8 deficiency. Then interferons used against the certain cancers and viral infections. Then interleukin 2 is also produced by this technique. Then TPA, that is the tissue plasminogen activator. Then essential growth factors. Then prouricokinases and vaccines are produced by using the rDNA technology. This is about the introduction of this biotechnology and how it is useful for the production of drugs or pharmaceutical products. Now we'll move to the principle of this biotechnology. We'll just go through this basic principle. Two important techniques which enable the development of modern biotechnology, that is alteration of chemistry of DNA and RNA to introduce into the host organism, to change phenotype of host by changing the genetic material. This technique is known as the genetic engineering. Then maintenance of sterile ambience to enable growth of desired microbes and eukaryotic cell in large quantity for manufacture of biotechnological products like vaccines, enzymes, beverages, drugs, etc. is known as the chemical engineering. Means biotechnology is the combination of these two, that is genetic engineering and chemical engineering. A sexual reproduction in organism preserves genetic information. And there is no variation of the genetic information from parent to daughter cells. But in case of sexual reproduction, it leads to variation undesirable gene with desirable gene. Genetic engineering isolates and introduced only one or set of desirable genes without introducing undesirable gene in target organism. Means only desired part is introduced into the organism by using this rDNA technology and undesirable part is removed. Techniques of genetic engineering: creation of recombinant DNA, use of gene cloning and gene transfer to host. rDNA cannot multiply itself until integrated into host genome. Means though you have recombinant DNA with you, without host cell you can't multiply it. When inherited in host cell, ability to replicate due to origin of replication initiates replication. rDNA linked with host DNA replicates and multiplies itself along with host DNA cloning. Gene transfer to host require vectors. Commonly used vectors plasmid. It is a small circular double-stranded self-replicating extra chromosomal material of bacteria, and it is used as the vector means transfer of these desired gene into the host cell with the help of this vector. First DNA was constructed Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer in 1972 by linking gene encoding for antibiotic resistance with plasmid of Salmonella typhimurium. Isolation of desirable gene, cutting out piece of DNA from a plasmid responsible for antibiotic resistance, which involves molecular seizures, that is restriction enzyme. And here you want to introduce the antibiotic resistant gene into the host cell, then that gene you have to isolate from the particular cell, and this cutting of the gene with the help of cutting of the DNA fragment with the help of restriction enzymes. Desirable gene, that is a DNA linked with plasmid to transfer into the host cell. Means that desirable part you have to link with this plasmid, and then that whole vector is transferred into the host cell. Linking of the DNA involves DNA ligase. Okay, DNA ligase is the enzyme acts on the cut DNA molecules and join their ends new combination circularly autonomously replicating DNA created in vitro recombinant DNA. rDNA transferred into E. coli DNA replicate using host cell. DNA polymerase multiply copies of antibiotic resistant gene known as the cloning, and E. coli will become antibiotic resistant. Basic steps in genetically modifying organism, that is identification of DNA with desirable gene, introduction of identified DNA into host cell, then maintenance of introduced DNA in the host cell and transfer of the DNA into its progeny. Then different tools are required for this technique, that is restriction enzyme, restriction endonucleases and exonuclease for cutting of this DNA fragment, then polymerase enzyme, then ligase enzyme for the joining of this DNA fragment, then vectors for the transfer of the desired part of the gene into the host cell, and for the multiplication of these rDNA host cells are required. Now we'll see one by one. Restriction enzymes, which is used to make cut in a DNA recombinant DNA technology. In 1963, two enzymes were isolated from E. coli, which restrict the growth of bacteriophage. One enzyme added methyl group to DNA and other cut the DNA and was named restriction endonuclease. Function of restriction endonuclease depend on specific DNA nucleotide sequence. First endonuclease isolated was HIM2. Studies proved that HIM2 always cut DNA at particular point by recognizing a specific sequence of 6 base pairs recognition sequence of enzymes. 900 restriction enzymes isolated from 230 strains of bacteria. Restriction enzymes belongs to nuclease class of enzymes. It is of two types. Restriction exonuclease remove nucleotide from end of the DNA. restriction exonuclease cut at specific position within DNA while naming restriction enzymes. First letter represent genomic name and second letter represent species name. E stands for Escherichia, CO stands for coli. Then R stands for the strain and I stands for the order of discovery. Okay, getting the difference between exonuclease and endonuclease means end part of this DNA fragment removed with the help of exonuclease and internal cuts are made with the help of restriction endonuclease at the particular base pair sequence. This part is known as the palindromic sequence. Okay, this is the example of double stranded DNA with the help of restriction enzyme. Cutting is there. After cutting, two parts of these DNA fragment consist of single stranded overhangs. That's why it is known as the sticky ends. And these two parts joined with the help of enzyme, that is known as the DNA ligase. These are few examples of restriction enzymes along with their source organism and palindromic sequence. Used in the field of genetic engineering to form recombinant molecule of DNA composition of DNA from different sources. Restriction endonuclease, same kind of sticky ends which can join by DNA ligase. Then we'll see the whole technique by using this diagram. Okay, this is the desired, this is the foreign DNA. You have to isolate the part of gene which you require to insert into your host cell from this foreign DNA. You have to make a cut with the help of restriction enzyme. Again, you have to take the vector and you have to cut the vector DNA with the help of restriction enzyme. Again, that this desired part we have to introduced into the vector, then with the help of enzyme ligase join these two parts, that is desired DNA and vector DNA, then you will get the complete structure of DNA in the vector. Then you have to transform this vector into the host cell, that is E. coli. Then cell division is there and then you will get the multiplication of this rDNA. Then next is the separation and isolation of DNA fragment. Now you have number of cells with the rDNA. How can you isolate this DNA fragment or how can you isolate this recombinant DNA from that cells? Action of restriction endonuclease reserves the fragment of the DNA and separated by gel electrophoresis depend on the negative nature of DNA. External electric field is applied to the medium and DNA move to anode. Means you have to separate the DNA from the cell. You have to make the cut into this DNA fragment and you have to separate it by using this gel electrophoresis. As the DNA is having a negative charge, then movement of this fragment towards the anode when electric circuit is starts. Medium used for the agarose gel, that is natural polymer extracted from the seaweed. The medium acts as a sieve and separate the DNA according to their size. Smaller fragment further separated DNA stained with the ethidium bromide and exposed to UV radiation, then bright orange color band of DNA in gel separated band of DNA cut out from agarose gel and extracted from gel piece, that is elution. Purified DNA fragment constructing recombinant DNA by joining them with cloning vector. This is the assembly of gel electrophoresis. This one is the cathode anode. Here you have to put the sample of your DNA mixture. Then you have to start with electric circuit. Then movement of this fragment is there. Smaller fragment move fast and longer fragment comparatively move slowly. And after separation, you have to stain this fragment with the ethidium bromide and then expose for the UV radiation and cutting out the DNA fragments. The DNA polymerase is an enzyme that synthesizes DNA molecule from DNA, the building block of DNA. These enzymes are essential for DNA replication, usually work in pair to create two identical DNA strands from single original DNA molecule. Or if you know, DNA ligase is useful for the joining of these two strands of the DNA by forming the phosphodiester bond in between them. Then vectors. These are the exogenous DNA to be inserted, stored and manipulated mainly in DNA level. This cloning vector is a small piece of DNA taken from a virus or plasmid of bacteria that can be stably maintained in an organism into which the foreign DNA fragment can be inserted for cloning purpose. Then these are the example plasmid, bacteriophage, cosmids, then ACV, that is the artificial chromosome vectors, then human artificial chromosome, bacterial artificial chromosome and yeast artificial chromosome. These are the examples of the vector used in the rDNA technology. What should be the features of this cloning vector? It should have the ability to replicate within the bacterial cell independent of chromosomal DNA. Then high copy number per cell. Plasmid 15 to 100 copies per cell, means per bacterial cell, this number of copies should be high. Aligned DNA, when integrated with vector, can multiply equal to copy number of vector. Then vector can be engineered for easy linking of foreign DNA and selection of recombinant from non-recombinants. Host cells are living system or cells in which carrier of recombinant DNA molecule or vector can be propagated. There are different types of the host cells of prokaryotic and eukaryotic. These are the examples. From group prokaryotic bacteria like E. coli, Bacillus subtilis and Streptomyces, for eukaryotic fungal species are used, then animal and plant cells are used as the host cell. This is the overview of this technique. Then methods used in a gene transfer, that is transformation, conjugation, electroporation, then liposome mediated gene transfer, then transduction and direct transfer. In transformation is a method of introducing foreign DNA into bacterial cell. The uptake of plasmid DNA by E. coli is carried out in ice cold calcium chloride and subsequent heat shock. Means what you have to do, you have to take the host cells, you have to take the recombinant DNA fragment or DNA with the vector, recombinant DNA with vector, introduced into the suspension of calcium chloride. Means after preparing all these, it will become suspension. Initially it was the solution of calcium chloride, ice cold at the 0 to 5 degree centigrade. Then you have to add your host cells, then vectors, then you have to give the subsequent heat shock. Means suddenly you have to increase the temperature for about the 90 seconds, and these heat shock generates the pores on the surface of your host cell, and immediately your vector is introduced into the cell. If you see this diagram, this is the plasmid, this is your foreign gene. Because of this heat shock, immediately there is a formation of pore and introduction of this foreign DNA into the cell. Next is the conjugation. Is a natural microbial recombination process. During conjugation, two live bacteria, donor and recipients, come together, joined by cytoplasmic bridge, and transfer the single-stranded DNA from donor to recipient cell. Then inside recipient cell, new DNA may integrated with chromosome or may remain free. Okay, this is the donor cell, this is the recipient cell, and DNA from this donor cell entered into the recipient cell by forming the cytoplasmic bridge, and after transfer of this genetic material into the recipient cell, either it is mixed with the genetic material of this recipient cell or this remain as it is isolated within this recipient cell. Then conjugation can occur among the cells from different genera of bacteria, for example Salmonella and Shigella cells. Then this is in contrast to transformation which takes place among the cells of bacterial genus. Thus, by conjugation, transfer of genes from two different or unrelated bacteria is possible. The natural phenomenon of conjugation is exploited for gene transfer. This is achieved by transferring plasmid insert DNA from one cell to another. In general, plasmid lacks conjugative functions, and thereof they are not as such capable of transferring DNA to the recipient cell. However, the plasmid with conjugative property can be prepared and used. Third method is the electroporation. Electroporation based on principle that high voltage electric pulses can induce cell plasma membrane to fuse. Then electroporation is a technique involves electric field mediated membrane permeabilization. Electric shocks can also induce a cellular uptake of exogenous DNA from suspending solution, same as that of your first method. Electroporation is simple and rapid technique for introducing genes into the cells from various organisms. Okay, in this technique, electric shocks are used for the generation of the pore to your cell, and in first technique, because of this heat shock, there is a formation of the pores and uptake of the foreign DNA. The basic technique of electroporation for transferring gene into the mammalian cell. The cells are placed in solution containing DNA, are subjected to electric shocks to cause holes on the membrane. The foreign DNA entered through the holes into the cytoplasm and then to the nucleus. Electroporation is an effective way to transforming E. coli cell containing plasmids with inserts DNA longer than 100 kilobase pair. The transformation efficiency is around 109 transformants per microgram of DNA for small plasmid and about 106 for large plasmid. This is the diagrammatic representation of electroporation. Here is the suspension of the cell. This is the DNA fragment we have to introduce into this solution or into the suspension of cell. Then you have to give the electric pulse. This electric pulse creates the pores on the surface of cells, and this foreign fragment entered into the cell. And then DNA entered into your host cell by using this electroporation method. Then liposome mediated gene transfer. Liposomes are circular lipid molecules which have an aqueous interior that can carry nucleic acids Several techniques have been employed to encapsulate DNA in liposomes. Means we have to prepare the liposomes in a such a way that it is you have to insert the DNA fragment within that liposome. The liposome mediated gene transfer referred as the lipofection. This technique is also known as the lipofection. On treatment of DNA fragment with liposomes, the DNA piece get encapsulated inside the liposome. Means encapsulation of DNA is there inside the liposome. Then this liposome can adhere to the cell membrane and fuse with them to transfer DNA fragment. This DNA entered the cell and then to the nucleus and positively charged liposome very efficiently complex with DNA, bind to cells and transfer DNA rapidly. Lipofection is very efficient technique and is used for transfer of DNA to bacterial, animal and plant cells. This is the diagrammatic representation. This is the liposome. This is the DNA fragment. This DNA fragment encapsulated within this liposome. Then this liposome added into the cells. Then because of this lipid nature, these are adhered to the cell surface. After fusion, fusion between the plasma membrane and liposome, there is a transfer of this foreign DNA into the cell, and then there is a formation of the recombinant cell. Next is the transduction. The foreign DNA can be packed inside the animal viruses. These viruses can naturally infect the cells and introduce the DNA into the host cell. Means ability of virus to infect the normal cells is used for the transfer of these DNA. Here you have to pack your desired gene inside the virus, and naturally virus introduce this DNA into the host cell. The transfer of DNA by this approach is referred to as transduction. This is the bacteriophage. Within this bacteriophage, you have to insert your desired DNA. Then this bacteriophage infect the cell, host cell, and genetic material within this bacteriophage is entered into the host cells. Then cell creates a new phase including phage and host DNA. Then transducing phase insert the donor cell. Then donor DNA included in recipient chromosome due to the recombination. Then direct transfer of DNA. It is possible to directly transfer the DNA into the cell nucleus. Microinjection and particle bombardment are two techniques commonly used for this purpose. Microinjection means the DNA transfer by microinjection is generally used for cultured cell. This technique is also useful to introduce DNA into large cells such as oocytes, eggs and the cells of early embryos. The term transfection is used for the transfer of DNA into eukaryotic cell by various physical and chemical means. Thank you. This is all about the introduction of biotechnology.